FedEx staff from New South Wales and WA have walked off the job today as an ongoing pay dispute intensifies just before the Christmas parcel delivery rush.
Fed up with paying conditions during lockdown, workers in Sydney began a series of national four-hour strikes, wanting work during lockdown acknowledged.
Victorian FedEx workers walking off the job this morning. Dozens of staff members carried placards at the company's Melbourne airport shipping location. It follows similar industrial action in other state capitals amid a dispute over pay and conditions.
Well, just like seven of the eight major transport operators across the country, these workers want a fair deal, cost of living increases in their wages, but more importantly, to lock in job security.
Everyone risks their lives to make profit for the company. We are the essential workers that delivered during troubled times. We didn't take a step back.
It's a pretty tough fight, and they just want basic pay rise and basic job security.
The international delivery giant is arguably the largest parcel company in the world. This year, FedEx came close to a $6 billion profit, revenue up by more than $14 billion on 2020.
FedEx made in excess of $5 billion in net profit last year. That's approximately $18 million a day. And now they're refusing to offer workers a fair deal, which will recognise their hard work during COVID.
It's not a question of them being unable to support these workers. It's a question of them being unwilling to do it.
The lockout by FedEx is the latest tactic in an ongoing industrial dispute in response to workers taking stop work breaks to secure more pay and better job security.
You know who's to blame if there's a disruption to deliveries? Only one, and that's FedEx.
FedEx has turned around. The US puppet masters have said, we're going to lock you out for 2 days. You won't be working for 2 days if you participate in this action. So, of course, that's going to cause much more disruption to customers.
FedEx need to recognise that and treat these workers the way they should and give them dignity and job security.
So we're here for the long haul, but what we need is FedEx to step up to the plate and finish these negotiations.
TWU National Secretary Michael Kane says FedEx is the only major transport company in Australia refusing to sign a new deal.
What FedEx needs to do is get back to the table. FedEx is the largest parcel company in the world. US management needs to empower the local team to sit down, give them authority to settle a deal.
I'm here because the trade union movement is 110% behind FedEx workers. It's a big US multinational that they are fighting, and they're fighting just for the basic fair go. And that's why we're all standing behind them today.
Workers in other states will take similar action later this week.
When workers' rights are under attack, what do we do?
Stand up, fight back!
What do we want?
Fair go!
Where do we want it?
Now!
And I say you, you, you say...